So I play Matthew Williams, who is Adam and Rachel's son, of course, all grown up now. He's 15. And you find Matthew at a point in his life where he's quite lost and quite lonely, to be honest with you. He's spent the kind of last 4 or 5 years at boarding school. He's not really had a close relationship with his dad. And obviously, having not been brought up with a mum and having no parent figure around or guardian, really, apart from Karen, he's been trying to navigate his way through teenage life on his own. And he just, as any teenager is at 15, 16, he just wants to work out and find out who he is. And when you're on your own and living quite independently, that's quite difficult to do. So he's trying to find out who he is. And at the same time as well, he's trying to rebuild his relationship with his dad, who is kind of, they've been separated really, you know, not entirely, they've still been in touch, but never as close as what they were when they were younger. And he's trying to get back that closeness with my dad. It was a dream. I was a fan of Jimmy before I kind of joined the show. So to be able to spend time with him, share a set with him, and, you know, what was learned from him as well, you can only describe it as a dream for a young actor like myself. Only downside to Jimmy is that he's a United fan. He could be an all-round amazing guy, and he is, but he's only one downfall. This is what I say to him. Is you're a United fan. But that aside, you know, building the relationship with Jimmy has been great, and he's so lovely. He's been so great with me, and I can't thank him enough for making the first series of my Kofi experience as wonderful as what it was, because it was a dream to work with him, yeah. Of course, the focus is still on the main five, who, of course, we all know and love, but you're meeting them at a new stage in their life now, and that is the stage of middle life, parents and teenage kids, and they all, that has a big influence on, well, I don't know, you know, I dare say as a parent, you know, your life does revolve around the kids, everything that you do and everything that they do as well has a massive effect on family life. So they're a big element in the new series because it has such an effect on what the characters do and where they're at, really. Families are kind of a big theme in the new series. Well, that's the thing, of course, we were all very aware that there is a wealth of expectation with the new series. Can it hit the heights that it did? And like you say, have that, bring that back to the new series. From my personal opinion, and, you know, I did watch series 1 to 5 before I got the part, after I'd got the part, sorry. I feel that Cold Feet essence is very much there and hasn't gone away at all. It's going to take you on that journey. There are going to be ups and downs, laughs and cries. And I think, fingers crossed, it's done again. Mike has done, and all the other cast, what Cold Feet did so well, and that is take you on that up and down journey.
One element of the show that isn't back is, of course, Helen's character. Can you talk about how the show continues that legacy?
Yeah, of course, that was such an important thing for the new series, and how do we kind of go about it? But I think the thing is with Mike and kind of, you know, us ourselves as well, she's not forgotten. You definitely very much feel Rachel there, and kind of hopefully see her in myself, and kind of there is a beautiful tribute as well and homage to Rachel in episode one with me and Jimmy, which is just the most perfect and fitting tribute. So hopefully you guys will enjoy that. And like I say, she is gone, but she's not forgotten. There's a few things, really. I think it's very real, which is sometimes hard to do, you know, and that's what made the old series, well, I think, first and foremost, so great and successful, was that people watched this and they could connect to them straight away. They could see themselves in characters or elements of themselves in different characters. So one, his writing is very real. And two, and he has this beautiful way of kind of building, you know, an extreme of one emotion, whether it be laughing or happiness, and then from nowhere, you don't even see it coming, we'll take you down there, and then you think, oh, this is really sad. And then he can just lift you straight back up. He makes a beautiful wave and a beautiful journey throughout all the scripts and the whole series, really. And that is down to the genius that is Mike. And that was one thing, especially, I remember when I read the synopsis for my character in the first two episodes, it was so refreshing to read for a teenager that had so many levels to him, and actually Mike brought to life so many issues that teenagers go through. You know, sometimes they go missing, and he seems to have done that with every character as well. So Mike's a genius.
Do you think we are going to get more series, hopefully?
You know, hopefully, you know, I would love there to be as well, just as a Cold Feet fan. But whatever Mike chooses to do, and kind of obviously ITV and everyone, whether this is the final chapter or whether there are a few more chapters to bring to life, whatever Mike chooses to do, I'm behind Mike, because Mike knows best with Cold Feet.